This Headless Professor video is about the distinction between qualitative and quantitative social science research. Qualitative research is based upon the narrative level. The data come to us in terms of words describing the subject on certain variables. Qualitative data are very rich in terms of what they tell us about the subjects. Quantitative data is numerical. In other words, we're measuring things in terms of ratio scales, ordinal scales, or simple nominal classifications. Quantitative data tend to be more precise. Now, there are many different types of qualitative research. Perhaps the most common and the most maligned is introspection, a simple self-reflection that each of us goes through when we consider why we think, why we feel, why we do what we do. Of course, a major problem with introspection is bias. The observer is the observed. Our own intentions and hopes become the data that we study. Many psychologists totally dismiss introspection as something inappropriate. I say it is inevitable. It is a starting point for our research, but it should not be our end point for research. Another qualitative technique is when we do an interview of another person, recording that person's words as our narrative data. An extension of the interview would be the focus group, where we have a number of people together interacting. And once again, we are interested in the qualitative analysis of what the people say. We want to look at the kind of decision-making people use in terms of the decisions that they actually come up with. Why did a person do a certain thing? Then we can focus on one particular individual in a case study type of situation. This is especially common in clinical practice, where we'll look at in-depth understandings of an individual's background to get an idea of the etiology, the diagnosis, the prognosis, and the treatment of a given disorder. Case studies, of course, do not prove cause and effect. No qualitative research technique does that. What case studies are very good at doing is illustrating the complex interaction of various causes and the different approaches to treatment and diagnosis. Another qualitative approach used particularly by anthropologists would be an ethnography, where we study a culture in depth. And many sociologists participate in that kind of study, and that becomes a participant observation study. Historians often use a document analysis, where they will look in depth at some historical documents written by individuals and trying to figure out an appropriate narrative for this. Archaeologists often use what's known as a trace analysis, where they look at certain physical objects that are evidence of individual activities of people long ago. The quantitative approaches are also quite varied. The great unifying feature of the quantitative approaches is that the data are numerically related. We could have a simple field count, where we simply observe the number of people at a given place, given time, engaging in a certain behavior. Similarly, we could do a trace analysis, but this time quantify it. Count how much wear or erosion there have been in front of the carpets of certain exhibits at a museum in order to determine which exhibits may have been most popular. We can also use those kind of quantitative techniques when we look at certain documents. Those documents could be employment records, student records, prison records, or they could be job applicants. Wherever we can simply do a count of the documents, that's a kind of archival survey. Then, of course, we can develop a questionnaire. Well, now, what differs a questionnaire from an interview is the questionnaire has very specific, quantifiable responses that are systematically given to every subject, not open-ended questions that are answered differently by each subject. Finally, we get to the experiment. The experiment is like a survey, except that it takes an independent variable and manipulates that variable. The usual way that this is done is to have two separate groups, and those two groups are the product of random assignment, not the choice of the subjects. The difference between qualitative and quantitative research is not only in technique or in the resulting narrative versus numerical data. These are actually two different phases in the cycle of social science research. We start with the qualitative to develop certain hypotheses. We then switch to a quantitative mode in order to test out those hypotheses. And then we go back into a qualitative mode to figure out exactly what the results of that experiment or that survey mean. So it's an endless cycle of deeper understanding of social science. That's the difference between qualitative and quantitative research. Two different blades of the scissors of science. Any questions? Contact me, Brink@USA.com.